Third question, we all missed him greatly, but in a sense, we were relieved. Who does we all stand for? Okay, roll number one. Speak the whole sentence, please. We all stand for narrator and his family and friends. Narrator's family and his friends. Okay. Who did they miss? Who did they miss? Yeah, they missed their pet, that is the sloth bear. Why did they nevertheless feel relieved? Okay, sit down, you better. Roll number two. Repeat, please. Yes, okay. So the narrator and the narrator, though he also missed Bruno, yet he was relieved because the pet sloth bear was becoming wilder day by day. It was growing up. So because of its huge growth, because of its the way it was growing and the way it was becoming wilder and was creating nuisance, it was a source of relief for them that it had gone. So its departure from the house was a source of relief for the family also. Got it? First, you have to mention, like, what kind of relaxation are they talking about? Though narrator was also missing him. Okay, the narrator also loved sloth bear a lot. Yet he was relieved because he knew that his presence, that the sloth bear's presence in the house would only cause more chaos and troubles. Because it was growing day by day and moreover was becoming more wild, was becoming wilder. So it was better that it was kept in the zoo. So he was, in a sense, relieved. Got it? Clear? So always keep on writing. It's not like what I say that you write. Be active in the class. Note down the things. When you're physically also active, you become mentally also a bit more active. Third question, we all missed him greatly. But in a sense, this we have done. So answer the following questions in 30 to 40 words each. On two occasions. Okay, roll number 3, 4. Roll number 4.
Online.
Okay, who is roll number 4, Arshdeep? Okay. Yes, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Speak first question, third part.
On two occasions, Bruno drank something that should not be eaten, drunk.
Speak louder, beta.
On two occasions, Bruno drank something that should be not be eaten, drunk. What happened to him on these occasions?
Yes. Okay, roll number 5. Speak the answer. Is he audible? Speak louder. First of all, you mentioned, like, what did he eat or drink? What did he eat or drink? What will you say? First of all, he consumed
barium carbonate,
which was kept in the library for the rats or mice. And he consumed it accidentally. And afterwards, his condition became quite critical. He was taken to the vet, and the vet, you know, treated him with great difficulty. And secondly, on second occasion, he consumed engenoid. Okay, let us ask somebody one by one. So, better be, can you speak the answer now? No, why? Why can't you speak? Yes. What's your name?
Harshdeep Singh.
Yes, Harshdeep Singh. What's the problem? Okay, roll number next. 6, 7. Give the answer. Read it. Keshav, you go to that side. Keshav, go to that side. You go to that side. Chaitanya, which question we are doing? We are doing question number 3, its first part. Okay, we are doing question number 3, its first part. Okay, last girl, Nav, you come to this side, second desk. Chaitanya, you go there. Yes, the other boy sitting with Chaitanya. Yes, stand up, speak its answer.
First time, the woman ate the barium carbonate in the lactating.
Okay. So won't you explain then what happened when he ate barium carbonate? Then what happened? What happened when he consumed the engine oil? Okay, find out the answer. Roll number, keep standing. Roll number 8. Yes. Okay, next roll number 9. Same answer.
When Bruno consumed the barium carbonate, then he was paralyzed, and then he was taken to the hospital where the doctor treated him. And another time when he consumed the gasoline of old engine oil, he drank a lot, and it doesn't affect him.
It did not
affect him.
It did not affect him. Why?
Because antibodies were already released then we consume the barium carbonate.
Okay. So what happened? Like, first of all, you'll explain the first part. Like, on the very first, Bruno was becoming wilder day by day. So one such example of his wild behavior was that he consumed barium carbonate, which was kept in the library for rats. After consuming it, his condition became quite critical. He almost had paralysis and was taken to the vet, where he was treated with utmost care. Then he survived with great difficulty. The second time he consumed a gallon of engine oil. And after this time, he did not have much, you know, he did not really suffer much because he had developed resistance against poison earlier only. So though he was able to survive in both of the occasions, but these two examples were enough to prove that his nuisance or his mischievous activities were nowhere which could be bridled by anyone very easily. Okay, he could not be controlled very easily now. These two things were proving this. Sit down. Okay, next question is, was Bruno a loving and a playful pet? And when did he have to be sent away? Okay, why then did he have to be sent away? So was he a loving and playful pet?
Yes.
No doubt that he was a playful and loving pet. But at the same time, we must say that he was becoming wilder day by day. His mischievous acts were becoming uncontrollable. So the way he consumed poison, in two incidents, that was enough to prove that he could do anything. So it was always, it was in the interest of all, including Bruno himself, that he should be taken away from house and should be kept in the zoo. So that was in the goodwill of the whole family as well as for this Bruno also. Got it? So how was the problem of what to do with Bruno finally solved? Roll number 13. Yes.
Yes, yes, please. Finally solved when he was sent to the zoo in Mysore, as the narrator, his son and his companion tried to convince his narrator's wife. It took her a while, but when she agreed to send him to the zoo, the narrator instantly wrote a letter to the manager of the zoo to see Bruno.
Did he write a letter to the manager or somebody else? Curator. Okay, now Raghav will tell
you.
If we take it comprehension wise, then first the final solution was that he should be sent to the zoo. Then in the end, ultimately,
finally,
okay, ultimately later on, it was brought back. You can mention both of the things over here. So I'm repeating, like when you are asked, like finally, what was done with Bruno? Then first, finally, you will say like he was sent to the zoo. Then afterwards, because narrator's wife and Bruno himself, they could not survive the separation. So it was decided, Bruno should be brought back home. And there it was provided a suitable environment to live, so that it would remain safe for the family as well as for Bruno to survive or to live together. Okay, so both of the answers would come back in this very point. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, next is thinking about the language. Find these words in the lesson. They all have E, I or I, E sound, I, E in them. So do this on your own. Okay, and in the test, these words will be there in the form of dictation. Okay. So now there are some more words. Complete them with E, I or I, E sound. Consult a dictionary if necessary. Okay. Do it. And I may check anyone's books. They must be done on the book itself. Is that clear? Then here are some words with silent letters. Learn their spellings. So knock, knee, arse, knock. What is silent here? K. Knee. K. Arse. H. Could. L is silent. Could. Wrestle. W. Half. L. Return. U. Return. Yeah, R is silent. Sign. G. Walk. Honest. Ornate. Island. Wrong. Daughter. Calm. Button. 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 They are. Yes. Listen to me. Listen to me. Here, U and O are the syllables over here. Okay. Button. Button. The second syllable is there. That is not there. I'll explain it tomorrow. I'll explain it tomorrow. Okay. Listen. What's up?